Hi everyone, and happy Skincare Sunday. Today we are going to be talking about kind of my tried and true ways to take care of the eye area. These are going to be tips and tricks, basically product usage and ways that I have found to really slow the aging process down around that area. So if you want to know more about that, hit that subscribe button, give me a thumbs up, and let's do it. Hey guys, I hope you guys are enjoying your weekend. This is actually a much requested video. You guys have been asking me for a long time to share some tips with you guys about how to care for this eye area. So I'm gonna try to basically talk about some of the most important ingredients that you can start incorporating into your routine no matter what age you are. A lot of these products I basically have either bought myself or they have been sent to me, but these are absolutely tested. I've been using these products, some of them actually for years, and others I've been using them for the past 5 months just to really make sure that they're really working. And so then we're also going to be talking about the ingredients, and we're also going to be talking about some modalities, which is tools, and then we're also going to be talking about some dermatologist kind of treatments you can do if topical is not working for you or to support your topical routine. So first I want to start with some things we need to think about the eye area. So usually our concerns are fine lines, wrinkles, puffiness, sagging, texture on the lid, overall kind of aging of that area, as well as darkness under the eyes. So darkness, I'm not going to touch on too much. The reason being is because there can be so many reasons for under eye circles. You know, your diet, your lack of sleep, it could be hereditary. I mean, look to your parents or your relatives, and if they have dark circles, most likely it's going to be hereditary for you. And honestly, there is not too much that you can do for hereditary dark circles. You can do quite a bit though for dark circles that are, you know, from lifestyle. Also too, as we age, the skin underneath here does thin quite a bit, and so you actually can see the veins and blood vessels a little bit more clearly, so that's why it actually looks a little bit darker. So that's why we're trying to keep the fullness that we have underneath here for as long as possible to keep that from kind of resting on those purplish, bluish veins that we have underneath our skin. So my first tip is to make sure that you are using eye products, eye creams that have retinol and peptides in them. So these are the two big powerhouse ingredients that you need to be looking for in your eye products. Okay, so these are going to be the biggest anti-aging benefits, as well as antioxidants for brightness. Okay, and then also making sure that you are using an SPF every single day around your eyes, okay? So, well, let's walk through this whole thing. Let's walk through my routine, and then I'll give you some other tips along the way. So, if you have severe swelling or darkness underneath here, you actually can try the teabag trick, where basically you have a teabag that has been lightly boiled and cooled down, so you don't want to put it on hot, but cooled down, you lay it on your eyes for about 20 to 30 minutes, and it really should help soothe that eye area, help with blood circulation to move that kind of puffiness out of that eye, as well as, obviously, if it's green tea, delivering antioxidants, and will help with that puffiness. So that's something that you can try and use. Also, eye patches. So I've talked about these a lot. I use eye patches a lot, and I find they really, really do help. And I will list below some of my favorite eye patches as we go through this routine. So every night, I have been using the Dr. Dennis Gross eye mask. This is a red light therapy mask. So it looks like this. You basically, I have skincare on. I don't want to put it on my skin right now, but you basically put it over your face. You leave it on your face for about 2 minutes, and it actually reaches almost to the depth in your skin that you would get from a dermatologist's office or an esthetician's office. So this red light will help with anti-aging, firmness, collagen production, overall fine lines and wrinkles, darkness, things like that. It's kind of a really beautiful machine that I absolutely use every day. Have been using this for, I don't know, maybe 6-7 months, and I love it. Have seen a big difference from it. So what it does is I basically cleanse my face, and then I put this on my eyes, leave it on for 2 minutes, and then continue with my routine, okay? So for my routine during the evening, I actually have little notes here that I've written down here and all the products I'm going to be sharing. So if you're looking at, that's what I'm looking at. Okay, so during the evening, when I do my eye care is, honestly, it doesn't really matter when you do your eye care. I usually do it before my oils, which is, I do oils and then moisturizer. So I'll go wash, if I exfoliate, essence, serums, and then in that serum step is when I do the eye care, and then oils, and then moisturizer, okay? So at night, I am religious. If you have followed my Instagram, you will know that I am religiously using this Murad Retinol Youth Renewal Eye Serum. I love this. I think that the amount of retinol in here is really superb. I think it absolutely does a fantastic job on really delivering retinol. The reason why it does an effective job is because it has a fast-acting retinol as well as a time-release retinol, which is really cool. So it's not just when you put it on, the retinol's there. It actually will time release all night and will deliver that retinol. You want to use your retinols around your eyes during the evening, okay? It also has hyaluronic acid in it. So you're going to see a lot of these products have hyaluronic acid in them because it's all about plumping, hydration, things like that. And then I will go in with my Skin Medica TNS Eye Repair. Now, I have recently, over the past, I'd say 4 to 5 months, been using this. You only need a very little bit, but this has really been a game changer for me. I think combining these two have really been game changers. There are peptides in here. What did we just talk about? That retinol and peptides are going to be the most important thing for anti-aging around the eyes. It also has vitamins A, C, E, and also has hyaluronic acid in it. I use both of these products around the orbital bone, and then I actually don't bring it right down to the lash line, but I do bring it on across the lid because this will help also with crepiness, texture, lifting, things like that. This, I just be very careful about how far I bring it down because it is more of a cream. So I pretty much stick to this around the orbital bone. So that is what I do at night. Okay, that I'm religious. I don't veer from that at all right now. I will, on the nights that I use my caca oil, which is very often because I can use this with a retinol for me, for my skin. I use a little bit of this, just ever so slightly, whatever I've left on my hands, right over that eye cream, just ever so slightly. I just like a little extra hydration. It's not going to give you milia or anything like that because you're not loading everything on. You know, you need the size of just a little pea of all of these products around that eye area. Don't load them up, okay? And then I just take whatever I've left on my, you know, from caca, and I just put it all over the orbital bone as well. Okay. Also, at nighttime, I am religious about Grande Lash. It is, in my opinion, when you have start having hooded deep set eyes like mine, having some lashes that kind of come up over that hood really open the eye up and brighten the eye up and make it look a little less hooded or a little less textured. And I find I use this religiously. When I started using it, I used it for a month, twice a day, once in the morning, once at night, but now I only use it at night and I have gotten amazing results. But I think using a lash growth serum is something that's really anti-aging to the eye because those lashes are nice and long. Revitalash also works very, very well. I've also heard very good things about the Rodin and Fields eye serum as well. So that is what I do. So it'll be step uno, step two, caca oil, and then my lash growth serum. Okay. Now for daytime, obviously, as you know, I absolutely love the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Eye Cream, okay? But what I've been doing recently over the past several months is I've been using the Drunk Elephant Eye Serum. It's, I don't know how to say this, but is it Shiba Complex Eye Serum? I love this. And the reason why I've really been noticing a fantastic result with this is because it has black tea. It has peptides, again. It also has plant stem cells. This is going to be something we're going to be talking about as the year progresses, is stem cells and growth factors and things like that. A little bit more clinical products, because as we age, stepping up your game into more clinical strength products is probably something that you're going to want to look into. So this also has black tea, peptides, plant stem cells, niacinamide, as well as CoQ10. CoQ10 is all about anti-aging and brightening, so it's really nice that you can have that in this guy. Love that serum. The last step during the day is obviously wearing an SPF. You know, I've talked about this for a long time. This is the Color Science Total Eye. It does a lot of things. It also helps with anti-aging, but it also is a color corrector for, you know, dark circles, but it has SPF 35 in it. So I have been religiously wearing this as well. So what that day looks like is we're going to go into serum. We're going to go into IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye. And I want to tell you a little bit about this. I forgot to. I'm so sorry. So the reason why I like this eye cream a lot is because it really helps and focuses on dark circles and smoothing out fine lines. It has skin softening technology. It also has vitamin C in here, collagen, hyaluronic acid, and peptides. Okay. And I have been using this religiously for almost close to a year now and really can't find anything that I love more than this. It really does smooth out that under eye. I love this thing. And then from there, I will go into my little color science thing. The thing to remember during the day is, again, the same thing as the amounts. You really want to make sure that you're using just a small amount of these eye products. I let my eye products kind of sink in for about 10-15 minutes before I go in and apply concealer and all of that, just because you need to let it sit, because you are doing these two layers, and you want to let it sit before you're going in with something like your SPF that is a color corrector, okay? So I hope that that makes sense. Now, if you're looking for more of a natural, very, very clean, more cleaner lines, these actually are not that bad. These actually are pretty clean lines, but I would actually go for Drunk Elephant. I think their products are very, very, very effective. They will never find any phthalates or sulfates or silicones or anything. They're really responsibly sourced ingredients, as well as this beautiful little eye cream by this company called Eminence. This is the Bearberry Eye Repair Cream, and I've been using this actually in place of the IT Cosmetics every once in a while just to try it out for the past 3 months, and it's actually been really, really beautiful. It is very, very clean. You can feel really, really great about using this. It's a very nice, lovely, rich cream, but still lightweight, and it just goes into the skin very beautifully. It has hardly any scent to it. This line is so beautiful. I've been trying some different stuff from this line, like an oil from them. It's really kind of beautiful. So this in here, this has bearberry extract, which is for brightening and an antioxidant again, as well as eye bright for firm and brightening. So firming and brightening. So these are all naturally plant-based organic ingredients in here. So if you're looking for more of that kind of routine, these are the ones that I would go with, okay? There's also some great drugstore options by a company called Rock. They actually have like Rock Retinol Eye Serums. I've tried those in the past and they're very, very good, as well as the Olay Regenerist line. The only thing that I will have to say about that is that they have a lot more fillers and you need a lot more of those products to get the results from some of these. So I'll just leave that disclaimer there and you can make the, you know, the decision which way you want to go. So takeaways from that are peptides, retinols, and antioxidants like vitamin C are going to be of the utmost importance in really making sure that you are anti-aging this eye area. There's one more product I wanted to talk about. It's by a company called Carez, and it's their Black Pine Eye Serum. Now, this is really targeted for people that have crepiness up here. You can use it morning and night. It also doubles as an eye primer. And if you have found that nothing else is working and you are doing all of these, you are doing a retinol and you are doing, you know, your vitamin C and your peptides and stem cells and none of that is working for you, you might want to incorporate, it's a serum based, you might want to incorporate that into your routine. So I'm just trying to give you a bunch of different products. You know me, I spend money on skincare. A lot of this stuff I've either been sent or I bought personally because I really invest in this eye area. All right, so let's talk about something that kind of can be a little controversial. Reason being is because not everybody agrees with fillers and Botox and skin procedures like lasers and stuff like that. But if you are into that, I did want to give you the information from my point of view. All right. So, so basically there's different things that you can do. You can go with something called, I have it all listed here. It's a Fraxel laser. It's a resurfacing treatment for under the eyes. And then you combine that with a little bit of a Restylane filler. And that is going to be, you know, the Restylane basically goes in and it plumps the skin. It'll take care of dark circles, fine lines. And then the Fraxel laser will be the resurfacing. So it'll take care of texture, fine lines, crepiness, things like that. So if you're into that, you might want to ask your dermatologist or plastic surgeon about that kind of treatment. You can also do something called an ultra therapy ultrasound treatment, and that actually stimulates collagen around the eye area. So again, for plumping and firming of that area. And then again, you know, your Restylane filler, because nothing's ever going to bring back the volume underneath your eye. You are going to have to add something to that, like a filler, okay? And then there is also, you can do thermage, which is a massage technique, which is basically this type of massaging technique where it stimulates blood flow to the skin. It's very similar to what estheticians do and what I did in my skin studio to really stimulate collagen production and stimulate blood flow and kind of lymphatic drainage and things like that. And then obviously you can combine that with your filler. Now, you know, I'm very transparent. I do have Botox in my forehead as well as just a little bit around my eyes. Around my eyes is a little bit more of a preventative measure. We can agree to disagree if you don't agree in that, but that does nothing to my skin except for relax the muscles. So any skincare I'm using does not negate how well it's working just because I have Botox. I believe Botox is amazing right here for either to stay off fine lines or to really relax the muscles so this area looks a little bit smoother. Again, this is up to your preference. I do not have fillers in my face, but I'll be honest with you, I wouldn't be opposed to it later on down the road, because do what feels good to you. If you're opposed to it, then that is totally okay. If you are into it, I just want to provide you with the information so you can be armed when you do go to your skincare specialist. All right, so that's basically it. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I am going to actually post all this information obviously in the description box, but I'm also going to put it on my llleary.com, and then you hit the blog section. You guys really liked that when I did that on Instagram the other day. I walked through my AM routine and then I put it all on my blog so it could live somewhere for you guys with pictures and stuff. So I will definitely do that on my blog so you guys can go there and just reference that if you need to. All right, so I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you found it really beneficial, and I am really, really excited that you guys were here today. Thank you guys so much. I love you all so, so much, and I will see you guys in the next one. Lots of love from me to you. Mwah. Bye, guys.